Section 14.3, example 7. Section 14.3 is not part of your e-text, but part of the original text from a previous versions of the class, covers multiple regression. This is similar to simple linear regression, where in simple linear regression you just have one explanatory variable or one x. In this case, you have multiple explanatory variables, and they focus on looking at two predictors or two x variables. This example here is actually looking at data from example two above, where you're using age and saturated fat consumed to help predict the cholesterol level in women. The data is above in example two. So this example asks you to construct a 95% confidence interval for a mean response and a 95% prediction interval for an individual response for a 32-year-old female who consumes 23 grams of fat saturated, or excuse me, grams of saturated fat daily, using the model determined in example two. Be sure to interpret the results. We're just going to go through how to do this in StatCrunch, since the instructions are a little or could be a little confusing. So the idea here is that we have a 32-year-old female that consumed 23 grams of fat. So we want to estimate her cholesterol, and we're going to use look at the prediction mean and the confidence interval for that. Excuse me, the prediction interval and the confidence interval. So let's go over to StatCrunch. Right here, I just copied the data from example two. So to do the multiple regression, we would go to Stat, Regression, Multiple Linear. We would select our Y column, that's total cholesterol, and our two X variables are age and saturated fat. We're not going to worry about anything else for this at this point, but we are going to go down and I'm going to show you, just like when we did simple linear regression, you have the hypothesis test or the confidence interval options. As you can see here, hypothesis test is automatically checked. Let's go ahead and click compute, and we see a very similar results as we saw for simple linear regression for with a single explanatory variable. So here's our equation. So here we're predicting cholesterol, and we have here our numerical coefficient for age and our coefficient for saturated fat. Now, this is asking us to find the confidence interval and the prediction interval for multiple regression. In simple linear, look, in single, when you have a single explanatory variable, it's very easy. If you go to simple linear, scroll down here, and it says prediction of Y, and you can put in the X value and the levels, and it'll automatically give you those intervals. However, that option is no longer available in StatCrunch for multiple linear. So you kind of have to do a little workaround. Remember, we're looking for a 32-year-old woman with 23 grams of fat. So what we're going to do is we're actually just going to create a new row, 32 for the age and 23 grams of fat. We're going to leave that Y variable empty. So now we're going to go back to Stat. We're going to go to Regression, Multiple Linear. We're going to select our Y column. You could have gone in and edited your last results, but I'm just showing you how to do it from the beginning. Again, we're going to select here. Now we're going to go all the way down here to what to save. So just like we did with simple linear with the residuals, all that stuff. Here we see the 95% confidence interval for the mean response and the 95% confidence interval individual prediction. So you select both of those and click compute. So now what it does is it creates these new columns, and it saved them for you right here. So you see here we've got the mean right there and the individual. So that tells you. So look, here's our results right here. Let's go back and compare. So that's 189.4 to 206.4 about. And looking at the results from what they found in the example, that gave us 189.4 to that 206.308 or 380, excuse me. And then for the prediction interval we have over here is 171.396 and 224.432. Let's look at the results, 171 and that 224. So what it did is it created this confidence interval and the prediction interval for this row, and it stored it. So that's where you would get it. So I hope that helps if you're working on the multiple regression and trying to find those in the prediction and confidence interval. Let me know if you have any questions about this.